Welcome back to Getting Started with Particle Illusion. In this part, we're going to take a look at all of the new usability enhancements included in Particle Illusion 2022.5. Particle Illusion 2022.5 includes a range of new enhancements. Probably the main one is the new 3D widgets feature. I've got an emitter here, and if I click and drag it, I can move it around on the stage. And this is current behavior. You can also click on this box emitter and I can scale it as well. And this is also current behavior. But if I click and then release the mouse, you can see a 3D widget. So now I can roll the mouse over an axis, for example, the Y. You can see it turns yellow. Then I can move it on that axis, or here on the X, or on the Z. If I move it over the box, that's going to move it on two axes at the same time, in this case, the X and the Y. Clicking on one of the corners of the box will also put a widget there, and that allows me to scale on the X and Y and the Z. You'll notice new buttons up here. First one is Translate mode. Keyboard shortcut is W. Next to that is Rotate mode, with the keyboard shortcut of E. And if I click back on the emitter, you can see there's the rotation widget. And these make interacting with your emitter much faster because you can do it directly here on the stage. Of course, you could always come back down into your controls and you could change the values here as well numerically. Next to that, we have the scale mode. Keyboard shortcut is R. And notice how you can see the R shortcut. That's also new. So tooltips will have a shortcut if there is a shortcut for that functionality. Scale mode works for some emitters. It depends on the different kind of emitter that you've chosen. Because this is a box, we can use scale. So here I can click and scale it on the Y and scale it on the Z, for example. On the right of that, we have the new world's coordinates option. Now, if I select that, nothing changes. This works in translate mode. So if I click on translate mode, you'll notice how the y-axis is now using world coordinates, which means it's vertical, and the x-axis is horizontal. So this is useful when your emitter is rotated, but you still want to move it vertically or horizontally. And if you use a 3D app, you'll recognize world coordinates, so it's nice to have that option here in Particle Illusion. Next biggest enhancement is to do with the nodes. Nodes up until version 2022.5 were purely for navigation purposes. But now they have some new functionality. First of all, if I double-click on a node, I can rename it. And that's the same for particle nodes as well. If you double-click on the icon, that will disable the node, which is super handy. Same for the particle node. Double-clicking on the gradient on the particle node will open up the color gradient editor, which is great. And also double-clicking on the particle will open up the particle shape editor. So this makes nodes now much more useful. Anything we can do to keep away from having to mess with these controls directly definitely saves time. Other general interface enhancements include a new name here for the project, and you'll also notice an asterisk next to that indicating that this project is unsaved. The file menu has a new open recent menu where you can find a list of your recent projects. And notice it also has a new revert functionality, which you can use to revert to the unsaved version of your project. Under the stage menu, you have a new zoom to fit option. Keyboard shortcut is F. Play in and play out have a new range option. You can see as I drag that, we can see the range. And when I move my cursor over the middle of that, you can see the play range, which is really handy. Holding down the shift key, we can snap to increments of 5. And if you move your cursor over the little white arrow and press the arrow keys, you can move forward and backwards one frame. So these are great enhancements for being a little less random when you're setting your play range. The current frame indicator also has the option for holding down shift and snapping in increments of 5. And also the particle time as well. Now to open up the project settings, up here you can click on the project resolution, And that will open up the project settings dialog box. And you can do the same thing by clicking on the duration. When you add a new particle or emitter, you'll notice that a number of different parameters are twirled open, which makes them just easier to access and prevents you having to twirl them down every time. And one last shortcut here on the timeline. First frame play in home, if I click that once, that'll take me to the start of the project. And if I click it again, it'll take me to the play in point of the preview range. And same with last frame play out. Click it once, go to the end of the project, click it again, and it takes you to the play out point. Okay, so those are the main new enhancements in Particle Illusion 2022.5. So thanks for watching. Remember, you can download Particle Illusion standalone for free, which includes thousands of free particle emitter presets at boriseffects.com, where you can also learn more about the plugin version of Particle Illusion, with features including built-in Mocha motion tracking, After Effects and 3D layer tracking, and text and mask emission, all at boriseffects.com.